There we go. No worries, I'm just switching games now. Because I have... This game has awesome music, but I also have one of the cooler characters unlocked on it. It wasn't long after your stream, Greg, when you were racing him on Mario Kart. He must have just gone round and followed everybody. He jumped in the other day when I was playing Subnautica, I think it were. Right, main menu, please. So, Devil May Cry 5 and some of the older versions have a thing in it called Bloody Palace. Bloody Palace is basically a boss rush mode. So I'm going to play around in that for a bit. So we have V, the mysterious one. Whoops. Devil Hunter Nero, who is my friend Ashley's favourite. You've got Dante, the old man. And you've got Virgil. So I will be playing as Virgil because Virgil's quite cool. So, am I missing anything on Virgil or do I have everything unlocked? Ooh, what am I missing? Oh, I'm just missing the fancy taunt. So Virgil, all the characters play differently. The way Virgil plays is he's got like a concentration meter. And that goes up with you not getting hit, not missing attacks, or I should say landing all your attacks, and not moving any more than you need to. So Virgil, you've basically just got to be like the cool guy. You don't move around too much. So... Virgil can teleport. That's his fancy thing. So you avoid walking everywhere. You move as little as possible and you use your teleports and stuff. So you can see my green bars, which are my health. The like blue pulsing one is his concentration. And then the purple one is his devil trigger that lets you do fancy things. Like that. So, always start with his best sword. And basically, you're just going to mix things up. And yeah, he can also, like, summon magic swords to throw at people. And the way combat works is the more varied you are in the combat and the more precise you are with it, you get a better rating. So these first couple of stages will just fly through. They're all tiny baby enemies, but see, I got hit then and my rating went right down. Oh, poor Mello. These things I hate. Although I got lucky that time. If you manage to parry them, you can kill them in a single hit like that. Right. We'll punch these guys. There we go, I got an S ranking for that one. Slowly getting there. So I think the first big fight should be coming shortly. And yeah, the music is based upon your ranking as well. So the higher your ranking gets in the fight, the more of the music is that turns up. So you heard the lyrics kick in then because I got to S rank. That's basically a free round. Now we go for the big one. This is it. Now for the big fancy attack. Max ranking. The part it gets tough is when we get to the actual bosses. Which shouldn't be soon, actually. I hate fighting these things. Right, bugger it. Now for the big sword guy. Missing all the attacks there. Right, we should be close to the boss now, it's not far away. What's this one? Most of them do, like they're supposed to just be creatures that live in hell, and they've just been sort of dragged here, most of them. Very few of them actually want to hurt people. Like the only ones that actually want to hurt people are like the big insect looking things. And then there's a few big badasses that... So these guys actually want to hurt people. These guys are cunts. So we're going to use this. Special attack. So the thing about the sword that the character uses is because it splits things. And he's half demon, so that ability there is him splitting himself up into his demon and his human bits, or it's supposed to be. Yeah, these things are ugly as fuck. This guy's a cunt because he teleports, so it's hard to get hits on him. There. Be rich in no time. So these guys are mean as well. These guys are purposely out to hurt people. Yeah, but they're some of the assholes. Everybody else is pretty just been dumped here because they're not supposed to be there. So they kind of freak out a bit. I think this might be the boss fight now. Yep. Get this in early. Get away from this. You know what we'll do? We'll go for the fancy move. Oh yes. Go full demon form. Caught me, but I should survive it. There we go, I did. He's gonna explode again. Oop. Got him. Now on to the next set of minions. Yeah, that was always a close one. So I used my purple bar is called your devil trigger. I used that right at the end just to be able to catch him. Oop. So you're on a timer as well with these, so you've got to try and get through them as quick as you can. So if your timer runs out, you're dead. Teleporting one again. Come back here. There we go. Lizards. There's a lot of lizards. And then we've got this woman. Take these things out because they heal her. Shrank for days. It's practice, like you cycle through the weapons and there's different points where the combos cycle best, so it's getting through them plus using your ranged attack and making sure to dodge at the right time. So it takes a bit of practice, but Virgil is the one that I am at it with easily. Right, this is going to be a fun match. Screwed it up, got hit. And again. There. Oh, we got more of a match yet. Right. Special ability time, where I'm all down a bit. These guys I dislike. Blech. Right, come on. Which one of you will die first? Bought it in. Bought it back. Yeah, they've got, like, any of the things you see with the big purple veins on have basically armor on them. So you've got to break through the armor before you can hit them properly. But they have, like, they basically have poise, so they can swing at you through that as well. And I got these guys. These guys can be very jank. Like, if you can parry these guys perfectly, you kill them in a single hit, these guys with the scissors. Otherwise, you're just going to beat on them. Yeah, this is Bloody Palace, it's called. So it's basically a boss rush, like there is an end to it. But it is every boss in the game with stages of enemies in between. And you're on a timer. Right, get fucked. Yeah, you've got to play through the game at least once to unlock it. Once you do, you just go through stages like this. The quicker you do the stages, you get bonus time. And then every, I think it's either 10 or 20 stages, there's a boss. Yeah, every 20 stages it'll be. But your health and everything is persistent throughout. So there are certain bits where you can heal, and certain abilities that cost you meter that you can use to heal. And that's it. So I'm going to use one of those now. So this ability will let me heal. And it's not really a stage clear, but it does a ton of damage to stuff. Like these little green things, they drop stuff that heals you, but they don't appear on every stage, so you gotta take advantage while they're there. Now we got this fella. I need to remember how to do Judgment Cut. Remember how to judge. In fact, I've got to skill this Donna. We are Yamato. So, to do Judgment Cut end. RB, let's stick forwards while concentration is at 2. Or whilst endeavor. Right. Right. I can't do it. Not at the moment, anyway. I'll do it when my Sin Devil's up full. I'm just going to try and deal with these things for now. Leave me alone, Fatty. Yeah. We'll pop this again. Use the healer for it as well. There we go. So my timer is up to 22 minutes at the moment, or 22 and a half. Right, what's next? Big exploding ones. Should be roundabout boss time now. Yep, seems like it. That scream I get caught by every time. Go for fancy finish, or try to. Right, that didn't work. Oh well. Oh, did that just kill me? Shit, he did as well. Yeah, the enemies are really well designed. They got 39 stages cleared. They get a D ranking overall for that, because it's like the second boss. So now we shall do it one of the other characters. So we'll do it with V this time. V is more of a summoner character. So he has two demons that work with him, three technically. And the demons can't actually kill things. V has got to finish them off with his cane. So you knock things down with his demons, and then once they're low, you kill them with V's cane. But you can power up the demons and stuff, so that's what we wanted. Double check 3. Rigor 2. So you're 100%. Nightmare needs... That's during a legal move, and legal move is... Which one is illegal move? Any steps with heart, we can gain or I gain her. Ah, well, not good enough mod for it anyway. So this will be pretty much the same, just with a different character to do it with. So it doesn't change much of the fights, if I remember right. See the orange icon around him, that's because the demons can't kill the other demons. Gonna wait until they're dead and then stab it with me cane. Yeah, this is about the only hat I've got. And I got it pretty much free when I bought Doom, because they had one left and they were trying to get rid of it. I will try as well with V, to try and get one of his taunts off, because you can use taunts to help hold your combos together. But if I get an S ranking on V, there's a really cool one I can show you. But normally he just sort of laughs and does this. This one I might be able to put on. There we go, S rank. Come on, do the taunt. He's doing it. Plays Flight of the Valkyries while he stands there composing it. And all of them have a taunt like this as well. But like the moves that the summons are doing here, I'm still controlling them. Like making them do combos and stuff. Like everything the bird does is controlled with the X button, and everything the panther does is controlled with a Y button. So you've got to manage both of them at the same time. Similar as you would with the other characters with the arranged and your melee attacks. But the downside with this guy is he can't dodge by himself. So if I need to dodge backwards or sideways or anything, it uses one of my demons to do it, which takes them out of the fight to do that. So you just need to kind of walk around and try and keep yourself safe if you can. There you go. Fight the Valkyries again. Calling my third friend. Yeah, that big golem thing is mine as well. It cost me my meter to use him. Yeah, the demons are technically part of him. They come out of his tattoos and stuff. And of course, like, the big demon is his hair. So when you call in the big demon, his hair turns white. Which is like its normal colour. Got hit. The demons can get hurt as well, like they have their own health bars. You can see on the top left. So if the demon gets knocked out, they're out of combat for like 10 seconds or something like that, or maybe 15. And you, during that time, you can't use them to dodge and can't use them to attack either. It's an absolute pain. These things hit me all the time just because I'm not good at fighting them. You have to sort of break their spines. And I can never do it quickly enough. So I always get hit a ton.
Right.
I think he's got unique kill animations for each of the enemies as well, like when he hits them with his cane. I know some of them have special ones, like this guy. Calling our friend for this. Yeah, these ones get a cool unique one. Like, he pulls out one of the eyes on them. Hi Dave. I am just playing around in Bloody Palace. So I was playing a bit of Dark Souls 3 PvP earlier, but I had a few connection issues, so I gave it up for a bit. And now I'm playing Devil May Cry instead. Where have you been? Did you manage to sleep after your stream earlier? Or is your sleep schedule still all over the place? That's good. My sleep schedule's all over the place at the moment, so I keep waking up at stupid times and things like that. Right, boss time! There we go, there's one of my demons knocked out. Although he comes back much faster, seeing as I've upgraded him a bit. Right, big friend time. Yeah, mainly beat him up. So this is Devil May Cry with the Devil May Cry 5, which is the most recent one. I'm doing Bloody Palace, which is like a boss rush mode, innit? Thanks, Bart. Thank you for gifting a sub to Div. I even got to see the fancy finish with this one, seeing as I had Nightmare out. I've access to the bears, and there are more bears coming as well. Bears. I think what I'm going to do, just realise what time it is, I will play through as V until I get murdered by a boss, and then that will be the end of the stream. So I'm just going to see how far I can get now. Thank you. So let's see how far I can get. I've got one boss down, see if I can get the second one. There we go, I've got the invisible bastard. Right. Here we go. Making my way to the next boss now. Getting close to that, the fork knife challenge. And then I get hit. Bastards. I'm bored as well. Bored just wants to see if I'm any better at it than he is. Seeing as he is the only other person we've seen play it on stream. Oh, I already stopped teleporting all over the place. There. Yeah, I need to see if my switch can connect to the wireless again, because it stopped being able to connect not long ago. If it is, I've got some stuff from them as well. That was easy. Oh, it's these clumps. Right, just Mr. Hansy to take care of. Oh, he's supposed to be attacking this one. There we go. Stop. stab it in the butt. Now we can take out these ones. Oh, they took out my pants for the bastards. Greg's at it as well. Check how far up are we with that? 36k out of 100. And we've got a couple of extra long streams in that time as well. It's alright, I will have Kelly coaching me when I play Forkknife. She has already agreed to it, so... Few people with loads of points who've like not been able to get on much recently. So like I know Abby's got loads of points because she was saving up. She saved up for origami and then didn't know what to do. So Abby's got at least 10k she could waste at once. And yeah, you agreed to coach me, Kel. Right, let's call him the big friend for this, because I can't be asked fighting these guys normally. Well, we get Brina in to coach me as well. I can see what it was like for you lot playing Siege. So I'll have to get him on Discord so I can pod him in like his own little coaching square in the corner. Tell him to put his camera on. Right, boss time. There we go. Here we go, knock her down, get the big damage in. Or try to at least. Boss is much tougher as this guy. I'm struggling to hit it. Don't get her. There we go. Got her. Right. Now for the extra crazy stuff. And we get a stage change as well. To see a world in a grain of sand. So There we go. Have fun, Beth. Just give me a shout if you need anything. I'll be waking up anyway. Just shout me on Messenger or something. Stop these things from healing it. There are monsters in the way. There. This is the furthest I've made it before on this. Shocked up. It's still hitting me. Get it. Those two over there. And their creepy eyes. Yeah. So we'll leave it here tonight, lads. We'll just do one more try, then we down the boss.
It's your turn.
Take out the healing ones first, please. Whoa, three queens. Stab it in the butt. Stab it in the butt. And get hit in the meantime. It's a good thing. Without Stab this one in the ass, and stab this one in the ass. Stab.
It's your turn.
There we go. It's the parry kill on that one. Seven more to the boss.
Now get to work.
There for three of the tentacle alligators. Not working. There we go, got some health back. That was close. Night night, Manu. Hope all goes well tomorrow. I will speak to you tomorrow at some point. Oh, no way. Not doing so well this round. Stop it. Teeny tiny bits of health left. Let's hope I can get some off these enemies.
Rise.
Not likely, but. I'm gonna take one hit for anything to kill me. Bit of help. Got lucky then. There we go, we're back up to about 2/3 health now. Almost in time for the boss.
Slice.
Yeah, all these things are dropping health, so I might even be topped up by the time the boss. There we go. Now it is boss time. Which boss is it? Oh, it's the knight. It is a giant knight who can teleport. And now he's going to do his big explosion. Took out my bird. Falling the big boy again. Knock him out of it. Nope. If you do enough damage to him while he's charging up, you can knock him out of that attack, but not having it. Tiger's down, calling the big guy again. Dragon's back up. I'm staggered. Oh, one last teleport. Get him. Big buy one last time, and he's dead. Fancy parry a finish. Nah, just the punch. I am now about 20 levels higher than I've ever made it before.
hold infinity in the palm of your hand and eternity in an hour. It's your turn. The angel that you sided on my post is a little creature.
No night bar. I am just going until I die at this point. I will probably speak to you tomorrow at some point. Yeah, they're like a meaner pinwheel. It's like the only way to stop them rolling as well. You either just beat on them until there's enough health gone that they stop doing it. Or if you parry them at the right time, you can break off all their spines and it stops them being able to roll. But the timing on the parry is really awkward. And we've got a teleporting one this time. Got him. There, we've got broken spines now, so we won't do the spinning thing anymore. I just gotta hope the big guy beats him up quick enough. Oh, it's one of the invisible ones here. The teleporter, I should say. Take care of the tentacles first. Gotcha.
your turn.
Oh, grab attack. Three of these guys. Oh, they got me. Game over. Let's see how far I got. 69. 69 stages in. I added an hour extra. An hour and 50 overall. Total play time, an hour and one. 49 minutes. Perfect ending. Right, I am going to head off now then. We shall find somebody to raid, shall we? So yeah, I was doing Bloody Palace as V last night, Dave, and I got to stage 69. So let's change this. Because I have the ability to play as Virgil as well, so I might do some as Virgil.
Devil may cry.
So, main menu. Playing as Virgil is great fun as well. Virgil, the Alpha and the Omega. I think I have everything unlocked for Virgil now. And yeah, V I quite liked. Like, I liked the whole summoner side of it. Right, we have everything but the stupid expensive one. Yeah, Virgil's fully unlocked. Maxed out all that as well. The best thing about Virgil, he's pretty much got, he's got Judgment Cut, which is pretty cool, but he has basically Air Trick and but yeah, the full screen Judgment Cut, I've not actually used much. Is it Yamato Judgment Cut End? That's the one that fills the entire screen. So while in Sin Devil Trigger, or while Max and Concentration is at level 2. RB, forward, Y and B. So when I'm using my Sin Devil Trigger. Like you can do that version. But yeah, the way Virgil works is you have to be precise, so his concentration meter at the top, that goes up and you get chunks knocked off it if you miss attacks, or if you move when you don't need to, like using your trick to teleport, like your air trick and stuff, doesn't count, but actually running round and things like that, or getting hit and it knocks big chunks off it. And Virgil does also have a V mod as well, but it's like a one shot thing, which I will show when we get a big chunk of enemies in. Right. Right. These are the ones that I don't like.
Yeah.
But yeah, every time I missed an attack then, it knocked my concentration meter down a chunk. Makes it harder to do the better attacks. This is the big one. Let's see if I can pull off the big judgment cut on this. Right. Sin Devil trigger. Big judgment cut time. These are the ones that I always struggle fighting. Bye, Bar. Have fun. Boss time. No, it says summon swords. You could basically use it similar to Dante's guns. But if you hit him with them, they create like a tag point for the teleport. Right. Send Devil Trigger time. No, it's literally, do you know the swords he summons like that? You can fire them the same way. So you can do like, you can summon them around yourself, you can fire them off one at once. Or you can do like, charge attacks with them. Although I need a target to lock onto to be able to do that. Can summon them and hold them like that and then go fire the lot. I will show you the V ability in a second when I get to the one of the bigger groups. Oh, bigger groups like this one. Would be one left, wouldn't there? But yeah, that's the V ability, and it costs you all of your concentration, or a big chunk of it, but sometimes it's well worth it. I hate these guys. There we go, got him tagged. There we go. Yeah, the gauntlets are pretty handy as well. Like, they don't have as many moves as Dante's does, but they have some much cooler ones. They use all of V's upgraded moves as well, so if you've upgraded V, he does more stuff during that part. Time. getting broken already. This boss is where I died last time. Daughter. Right. I think I'm going to go until I die. And then I'm going to end this stream. So I've been on for quite a while today. Got me.
Rainbow Spring.
They're already, Dave. Nice. Oh shit, three of them. Pop this out straight away. That is me dead. Did not make it as far as I did with V, but did alright, 49. So, I shall be ending the stream there for today. I'll be back on Saturday with some Dark Souls, so I shall see you all then. Let's find somebody to raid in the meantime, shall we? Oh, let's see who's online, if anybody. Let's have a look here. Right, can't really see anybody I know online, so let's find somebody random to raid. Anybody playing Devil May Cry? Let's have a look. Oh, we got somebody else doing Bloody Palace. Let's go and see him. And I shall see you all on Saturday. Go and say hello to this guy. He's also doing Bloody Valis. He's also doing it as Virgil. He is actually on the mission I just died on, I think. But he is well ahead of me. Yeah, stage 50. So yeah, he is literally just ahead of where I was. Well, see you all on Saturday. Goodbye.